Hello everyone and welcome back to the Perfect French with Dylan. Today I have a very interesting lesson for you. We are going to see all the different se in French. I've been working on this lesson for a couple of weeks. Last week we saw the last lesson about the French demonstrative adjective which se, CES is a part of. So I wanted to finish to explain every single one in details before doing this recap. So if you want to have more information about all of them, I'm going to put the link of all the videos in the description box. They are all pronounced se, se. So since they are pronounced exactly the same, it's really hard for French learners to know when to use them. So today we are going to see everything about it, and don't forget the free PDF so you can review and never forget the differences. So let's start with se apostrophe est. C'est, means it is, this is. We use it for four different things. We use it for people and things. We use it for opinions. We use it for jobs. And then we use it for nationalities. And it doesn't matter if after it's feminine or masculine, it's always going to be c'est. So if you look at the first point for people and things, we can say c'est un vase. C'est un vase. Or, c'est un beau vase. C'est un beau vase. It's a vase, it's a beautiful vase. So that's masculine. Now if we see for the person, c'est mon frère. C'est mon frère. It's my brother. C'est mon petit frère. C'est mon petit frère. It's my little brother. Now let's see for the feminine. So if we have a feminine noun, we have c'est une fleur. C'est une fleur. Or with an adjective, c'est une jolie fleur. C'est une jolie fleur. It's a pretty flower. Then for a person, c'est ma sœur. C'est ma sœur. C'est ma grande sœur. C'est ma grande sœur. So that was for people and things. Now if you want to give your opinion, you're also going to use c'est. Never il est. If you want to know more about c'est and il est, the video is going to be in the description box. So we can say c'est beau. C'est beau. It's beautiful. C'est bien. C'est bien, it's good. C'est bon, it's good as well. I also have a video, bien and bon. I will also put everything in the description box. Then we have, c'est super. C'est super. It's great. Now let's see only one for jobs and one for nationalities, because it's the less common way to use c'est. So for jobs, c'est un avocat. C'est un avocat. Lot of links here. C'est un avocat. He's a lawyer. For nationalities, c'est une Canadienne. C'est une Canadienne. So you see that the top one is a masculine one, the bottom one is a feminine one. And even though c'est doesn't change, second one, s apostrophe est. For this one, we'll have to do a little bit of conjugation. And we are going to see the reflexive verb se lever conjugated in passé composé. So we have je me suis levé, tu t'es levé, il s'est levé, elle s'est levé, on s'est levé, nous sommes levés, vous êtes levé. Ils se sont levés. Elles se sont levées. So I don't have enough space to add the English translation, but that means I got up, you got up, he got up, she got up, we got up, etc. The translation is obviously on the PDF, because on the PDF I have enough space. So here, you probably already saw it. S apostrophe est is with il, elle, and on. So this is basically that. It's a part of the reflexive verb conjugated in passé composé. That's the only way you are going to have c'est. S'est. Let's see in a sentence. Il s'est levé à 6 heures. Il s'est levé à 6 heures. He got up at 6 a.m. Next one, C-E-S, c'est. C'est is a French demonstrative adjective. We saw that very recently, so I'm just going to give you back the little graph that I have for it. So for the singular, which will be this and that, we have three different ones. We have ce, cet, cet. And then for the plural one, which will be these and those, we have c'est, c'est, c'est. So that's the one that we are looking at today. Let's see two examples. Ces fauteuils sont confortables. Ces fauteuils sont confortables. These, those armchairs are comfortable. Or, ces couleurs sont vives. Ces couleurs sont vives. These, those colors are bright. So here, fauteuil is a masculine plural. Couleur is a feminine plural. And you can see that it doesn't change. So when you want to say these, those, use C-E-S. The next one is S-E-S, and of course also pronounced C. This one is also very specific. This is what we call a French possessive adjective. So the other one was a French demonstrative adjective. This one is a possessive adjective. Let's review all of them and then you're going to understand very quickly. So here we have also three different categories. We have masculine singular, feminine singular, or plural. So we have mon, ma, mes, ton, ta, tes, son, sa, c'est, notre, notre, nos, votre, votre, vos, leur, leur, leur. So here we are only interested about one, it's S-E-S. So it's a very, very specific one. And it means his, her, or its. Let's see two sentences. So we have ses écouteurs sont cassés. Ses écouteurs sont cassés. His or her headphones are broken. Next one. Ses habits sont secs. Ses habits sont secs. His or her clothes are dry. We are almost done. We have two more to see, and it's S-I-S, S-I-T. You are going to understand why I put them together, and we are also going to do a little bit of conjugation for this one. We are going to conjugate the verb savoir in present tense. So we have je sais, tu sais, il sait, elle sait, on sait, nous savons, vous savez, ils savent, elles savent. So here we have five different lines with c'est. We have the two first ones, which are s-i-s, and then we have the three next ones, which are s-a-i-t. It basically means I know, you know, he knows, she knows, we know. That's it. As simple as that. So let's see two sentences. We have je sais cuisiner. Je sais cuisiner. I know how to cook. Next one. Il sait rouler à vélo. Il sait rouler à vélo. He knows how to ride a bike. So when you say how to in French, we don't need to add that after savoir. We just add the verb right away. You know everything about the difference between all the c'est in French. I hope you will not make the mistake again. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like this video if you liked it. Leave me a comment if you have a question, I will do my best to help you. And I will see you soon for another lesson.